Today we will learn how to programming with ComfyUI. My ComfyUI server is running. Let's close this workflow and get the default one which is coming with ComfyUI. As my ComfyUI server is running and default workflow is there, let's try to run the default workflow first and ensure it's working and generate the images in a proper way. Let's use the default prompt by clicking on Q button. Ops, it's giving error because model is not present in load checkpoint. Let's select a proper model and try to run it again. I will choose Dream Shaper model here and run the workflow again to generate the image. It will take some time to load the model and image for first time. Now the image is going to generate and show in save image. Now clear the workflow. It's time to work with Visual Studio to run my existing Python web app, which is now generating the images using Flux model. It's full stack web app, but I will only show you the image generation part by using Python programming, which will generate the image by programming and using the ComfyUI workflow save as API formatted JSON file. This is the front end of the web app, which can generate images by using text prompt. After writing the text prompt, user click on generate button and it will use the local ComfyUI server port 8188 and generate the image locally. Let's give some text prompt and check it's working or not. Before doing that, I want to ensure that ComfyUI server is running and processing the text to image via ComfyUI server. Wait for a while, it's loading and processing the image using Flux workflow and Python programming for this web app. By 2 to 4 seconds, it will create the Flux 4-step image and show it on the web app locally. Very cool, right? Let's try a few more prompts and see the results. Here is some other prompt I want to try and generate image locally. Again, it start processing the image by calling ComfyUI server port 8188. And within 2 to 4 seconds, it will generate the image. Cool output again, right? Let's try to log in the app using Google. When user click on login, it will show the Google login option, and user can select Google user ID to log in this app. It will show the balance for the user and subscription status here, it's showing free. Let's try to generate another image before we proceed to the programming part. It will follow the same process and generate the image locally using Flux model and ComfyUI workflow locally. In the next episode, one will show you how I did the programming using Python and call the ComfyUI workflow API JSON formatted from this web app.
Before we start programming with ComfyUI workflow and Python, we have ensured that ComfyUI server is running locally. After that, we can start programming by using Visual Studio coding. Here I will share with you the details how I did that. Here I made one directory named text to image app and under that its standard folder to run one HTML website which you use to get by using any standard coding format. HTML file template is linked with CSS and JavaScript. Let's navigate the CSS file and JS file. It's a normal CSS file. I will provide the entire project after this 4 episodes video and you can enjoy full stack AI code. Watch the code CSS and JS coding part before I drive into Python coding part. JS file is also very simple. Few lines of code, that's all. Watch it carefully, you will understand it. Before I proceed to the index file, let's close the folders so it's not make any confusion. I used a Flux workflow here which will be also attached with the project code. Here is main index.html file where user can type prompt and click on generate button and it will pass the prompt text to backend Python program and Python program will call the workflow JSON API formatted file and send the request to ComfyUI local server port 8188 and execute the workflow to generate images. I used Google login authentication here for which code is little bit lengthy. You have to create a directory first and then you can create an environment file to install dependencies locally so it's not make any problem with other version of Python. Create a.env file to store API keys and other secret keys. I can't show my original .env file but I provided a sample.env file with project code which will help you understand. So far easy, right? I also provide the requirements.txt file which you need to run. Step-by-step guide I will add in a README file with this project code so installation and run will be hassle-free. You if encounter any problem while installing dependencies then you can remove the version no also and follow the installation process from the begin again. Let's navigate the workflow.json API formatted file and check how it looks like and where to pass the value for text prompt. Workflow is not big and workflow file API formatted will be included with the project. So it's easy for you. You can run this JSON file from ComfyUI workflow area also. Let's check out where to pass value in this JSON file. In the top of this workflow there is a class type named clip text encode, and under that there is field named text where the prompt for this workflow value pass to generate the image. So while writing Python code we have to use this class name and field name to send value to this API formatted JSON file and send the request via Python programming to ComfyUI server. So let's check the code of main Python file name app.py first. I will explain the code part by part here. Importing necessary libraries. At the beginning of the script, several Python libraries are imported. Additionally, custom modules such as user_management handle user-related database operations, and workflow1 manages the workflow for image generation. Authlib for OAuth authentication are also included. Directories for storing output images and static videos are defined. The script ensures that the directory for storing videos exists by creating it if necessary. The main code for generate image is here. You can try this code part and can implement in any project in future only by changing class name and field name. There is another Python file name workflow1.py which imported in the begging of the project. This highlighted part can be also used if you want to avoid Google authentication. There is many way of modify and run the code. Let's check the another Python file where class name and field name is used for get the value from HTML front end, pass it to backend server and send the request to ComfyUI server port. Here is the workflow1.py code. It's right in the same fashion, importing required libraries first and set the output folder of ComfyUI where generated images will be stored. It's the default output directory for local ComfyUI. Then set the database if any user management system you want to maintain. It's necessary to open ComfyUI server connection via WebSocket for ComfyUI local port 8188. Then it will send the queue for generate the image to ComfyUI server port. If you run any ComfyUI workflow from work area of ComfyUI, it's also generate a queue. It's same. Next part of the code is generate the image from workflow file by using the text prompt value that you will get from HTML web page. While generating the image ComfyUI server do many things in the back and finally process the image by a node named ksampler. This part of the code will show the progress of ksampler. I used this part of the code for debugging purpose. You can comment this part of the code if you want. For the beginner I will suggest to keep this one and use some JavaScript in the front end to show some animation message like generating image. Last two part of the code is show the image in content placeholder of index.html front end from ComfyUI output folder. I wrote a code logic where every time it will search for last generated image checked by timestamp. This part of the code is loading the workflow to pass the text prompt value in the back end. Last part of the code is the most important because here we wrote the code for using class name of the workflow with the field name to pass the front-end value get from user to back-end via this code part. You can add many fields here and send the value for the other workflow fields. In my next few episodes of the advanced video I will show you how to create video by using CogVideo workflow using Python. Wait for 1 week it will be published. If you like my channel don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Let's run the code and see how it's work. Now code already generated port 5000 locally. Open the link and watch the website how it's looks and work. Looks cool, right? Now I will copy paste some of my existing flux prompt to get the results. I will try 2-3 prompts and show you how backend and frontend working together locally. In the future video I will show you how to connect your local machine as a server to publish and connect it with this website and give access to other and help them to learn and enjoy this kind of workflows. So seat back, relax and enjoy the rest of the process with background music. If you want more professional video like this, don't forget to watch the full video and subscribe this channel.
In today's video, I will show you how to connect your local ComfyUI server to web and share it with your fiends. First check that ComfyUI server is running or not. Then open the project that I showed you again. Name was Text2ImageApp. Open the project from Visual Studio Code. And open terminal and then type python app.py. It will open the 5000 port for you locally. Click on that 127.0.0.1:5000 link. It will open in new tab in your browser. It's the same program we seen in the last video, right?
Cool.
As I used some prompt before, so there is some prompt in the memory of the browser. Let's try one prompt first. After took one prompt, click on generate button and see the results. Yes, Comfy UI server processed the image by running the workflow. And here is the result. Let's try another prompt and check it, then we will proceed to the next part of this video. Do the same, forget the prompt, or you can type your own prompt and click on generate button and it will create the image by using backend Python code and Comfy UI workflow from server. Here is the output. Let's proceed to the next step for make this project live on internet. Open a new tab in your browser and go the website of NG Rock. It's free, only need to register and download it for use. Click on sign up and after that, get started for free and download the desired version. For Windows, go to download tab and download the file. After download it, extract the file. In the download page, they will provide you one authentication token. Just copy that link and keep in your notepad. For me, I downloaded that file already and extracted in my download folder. Let's open that folder and run the command for use it and see the result. Here is the ng-rock application file. Double-click on it for open the command window where you can type the command to run a particular port which is running locally to open it for internet. As our web app is running on port 5000 locally, so it's a HTTP port, so when you need to open this port for public use in internet, you need one HTTPS secure server port. Here is the magic. ng-rock will create a HTTPS port address for you. Let's check how to do that. In this command prompt, I will type ng-rock then space HTTP then space again and then port number 5000 and press enter key. Watch the full video carefully so not missed any steps. After few seconds, it will create a new HTTPS port by forwarding our local port information to NG Rock server and generate a unique HTTPS port for us. Copy the which I highlighted here by Ctrl plus C command from keyboard. I will minimize the command window and open a new tab in the browser and paste that link for test the link. After paste the link and hit enter, it will open the same web app page which is running locally. Congratulations, your Comfy UI workflow is live on internet and no need pay extra server to host and run your workflow to make money. Let's try some prompt to check its work or not. Yes, it's processing the image by the text from provided in that globally available page and generate the image. Let's wait few seconds to get the image results here. Yes, here it is. Very cool, right? Let's try with some more prompts and see the results. I will provide the source of this project in the description below and you can download it free, which includes everything. Open the readme.md file first. Entire installation process is there. Feel free to write me if you facing any problems. As I mentioned in the earlier video of this series, it will be four-part video series, that's why in the next video I will show you how generate video from using same way by typing text prompt. If you like my channel, watch other videos, share it, like it, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel to get same kind of video like this. Thank you for watching my channel.